A 1,000 ml IV solution is ordered to infuse over 8 hours. The flow rate is 120 ml per hour, and the drop factor is 20 drops per mil. We want to find the drops per minute. So to answer this question, we're first going to find the flow rate in mils per hour, given here by this quotient. Then once we find this flow rate, we can find the drops per minute by performing the substitution here to finally determine the drops per minute. So to find the flow rate in mils per hour, we would have 1,000 milliliters divided by 8 hours. This would be 125 mils per hour. And now we can use this flow rate to determine the drops per minute. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So the drops per minute will be equal to 125 milliliters per hour times the drop factor, which is 20 drops per mil. We're going to divide this by 60 minutes per hour. Again, if we're doing this by hand, it's going to be helpful to simplify this first. Notice 20 and 60 do share a common factor of 20. There's 120 and 20 and 320s and 60. So this would be equal to 125 divided by 3 drops per minute. Let's go ahead and find this quotient. 125 divided by 3. There are 4 3's in 12. 4 times 3 is 12. We subtract, bring down the 5. There's 1 3 in 5. 1 times 3 is 3, and we subtract. The difference is 2. We're going to round to the nearest drop, so we'll have to go one more decimal place. So we'll put our decimal point here, move it up to the quotient, add a 0, and bring it down. And there are 6 3's in 20. 6 times 3 is 18. Subtract with a remainder of 2. Because we have a 6 in the tenths place value, this means you round up, so we round to 42 drops per minute. Of course, if we're allowed to use a calculator, we could check this quotient. 125 divided by 3. Or just to verify that we simplified this correctly, we could enter 125 times 20 in parentheses, and then divide by 60, the original denominator, with the same result. I hope you found this helpful.